Double XP live this Friday. Logout timer extension this week in RuneScape. All right, July 24th, game update. Okay. Prepare for necromancy with double XP live. New cosmetic pack and your guide to the city of Okay. Have you seen your progress? You have such potential. Keep growing stronger. I will be watching. Raciel. So Friday the 28th, 6 a.m. if you're in Central, I think. Time. What time is it right now? Yeah. 5 a.m. for me? Okay. But yeah, probably 5 or 6 Central. Alright, with the necromancy just around the corner, now is the time to get your levels in order. Ready to strut your stuff in your new necromancy armor? Try grabbing some extra levels in crafting, or maybe you want to make some necromancy potions. Better get your herbler up to scratch. Oh yeah, yeah, so make sure you make overloads before next week, or before necromancy comes out, because then you're going to need an extra potion to make overloads. So it'll be like extreme necromancy potion. I wonder what that entails, honestly, because there's no new herbs that I know of that we're gonna like, unless it's gonna be like two things combined into one. Like you need Lantidimes and Torsal to make one necromancy potion or something. We'll see. Okay, if you're preparing for necromancy, here's some optional levels to chase that can support your journey in necromancy, though none are required in order to play the skill. Alright, so if you're just starting out, 15 smithing, 15 crafting, 20 rune crafting, 10 prayer, and 11 herblore. Okay. Well prepared, 65 smithing, 65 crafting, 40 rune crafting, 46 prayer, 79 herblore, and the quest Temple of Seniston. And ready for everything is basically all the quests: Kings of Ransom, Ghost Ahoy, Jack of Spades, Vengeance, Nadir. The Blood Pact, 107 Herblore. Oh, okay, it wants 107 Herblore. Wonder why. 99 Prayer, 60 Rune Crafting, 85 Smithing and Crafting. Okay. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You gotta do a lot. You have a lot to do. Okay, but DXP is a 10-day event, so you have 48 hours to use it. You can pause the timer as you need. But like once you pause the timer, if you turn it back on, you can't pause it again for another hour. So just make sure you know that. Also, if you log out, the timer doesn't tick. So, but I don't know about last time, whenever I was in the lobby, it was still ticking down. So I don't know about that. Elvis, it's always been 10 days, like in the last like 2-3 years, it's always been 10 days, but you have 48 hours to use those 10 days. I mean, you have 10 days to use those 48 hours. I got bed hair? A little bit, yeah. Little bit. I know this because of an extra DXP because of, this is an extra DXP? Oh, you thought this was just a weekend. Ah, okay. No, it's a full week, right, like, all the way up until August 7th, so it's kind of cool. So as soon as double XP ends, necromancy starts, so it's pretty sick. Pretty cool. Also, if you won't be using all your hours, you can trade in an hour of double XP per day for credits with the Nick the Trader. Nick the Trader doesn't really have that much. It has like 1 hour is what? I don't remember exactly what it was, but it's, let's see. Let's open this. Let's see what it says. What is this? Oh, how does double XP work? We don't need that. I think Nick the Trader is kind of a waste, but if you're not using it, then might as well. Because I think you need 40 credits to get one lamp, like one medium lamp, that's kind of, or a large lamp, it's like nothing. Currently, players can trade 1 hour of, 1 hour a day with Nick for credits, which can be spent on items. Previously, these credits could have been carried over the XP periods, but this will no longer be the case. Oh, really? Oh, wow. Yeah, yeah, because I left all the credits from last double XP over, but this now they want you to spend it all at once. Okay. Damn. And for everybody with Jagex accounts, logout timer extension. As previously mentioned, we're actively working on increasing the AFK logout timer as part of a Jagex account. This goes live today. Update, nice. Previously, the timer would log you out after 5 minutes. Now it's twice that. You've got 10 whole minutes to step away. You can safely go make coffee, change the filter while you're there, maybe get creative with a few syrups. Yo, dude, that's so nice. Oh shit, the light. yeah. Hell yeah, hell yeah. 10 minutes. I was expecting because it's 5 minutes. I thought they were just gonna increase it to like 7 minutes, but they doubled it. 10 minutes, sweet. It's not a prank. It's not a prank. Alyssa, were you here with the golden cape? When was the golden cape? The golden cape was like 2 months ago, right? You got the golden cape? Yeah, yeah. So during the golden cape, they were announcing like, oh, if you join Jagex account, you're gonna get a increased AFK logout timer soon. Yeah, dude, I missed the golden cape assignment too. All right. This is just one way we're using player feedback to improve Jagex account. We'll continue to refine these systems, so keep sharing your thoughts with us. Although it takes, sometimes people have problems with switching over to Jagex accounts. I kind of like it. The Jagex account, like, I know my password, but I don't have to know my password every single time, I guess, to log in, because it stays log in, kind of. Although I do log out periodically, so just so I could remember my password so I don't forget it. All right, Necromancy Insight. All right, take a tour of the city. Of the city of in our latest insight blog. Oh yeah, if you haven't seen it in I can go through it real quick. Just looking at the pictures. Oh wait. It's not letting me click on it. It's not linking to me. Okay. Oh well. If you haven't, go on RuneScape website. There's a bunch of pictures of the city of It looks pretty cool. But yeah, more of a fighter than a tourist. The next Insight release will dive into the combat aspect of Necromancy. Oh, okay. So Thursday, we're going to get combat aspect of Necromancy. A sneak peek about upcoming abilities and all the info on how you'll be slinging that necrotic energy when the time comes. Okay. What? It should be 25 minutes. 10 minutes is pointless update. Nah, it's better. It's better. I mean, it's double, right? So 25 minutes seems too long. I know old school has 25 minutes, but most of the things that you do in the game, like after like 5 minutes, you just stand there, right? Yeah, but like even on old school, like if you're mining, you're not going to just continue mining for 25 minutes. The only thing that old school helps with is if you're doing like some boss that you can just AFK for 25 minutes. Yeah. But then you just click and you don't log out. Yeah. But 10 minutes is good. I don't think we need... I think 25 minutes is a little too much for even old school, even though they have it. If it's a plug... Also, because Runelite is a plug-in, right? Like, they should just increase it to an hour. Yeah. Make old school Runelite permanently logged in forever. No, but 10 minutes also... Like, when you're logged in, it kind of, like, uses more resources, right? So maybe logging out is a good thing. But anyways, alright, let's see. Livestream calendar. Join Mod Doom and Mod Sphere as they kick back and grind some levels on Wednesday. I'm opening...
And that day may never come and, upon you to do a service for you.
But until that day...
But until that day...
Except justice
is a gift on my daughter's wedding day.
Yo, what's up, Panda? Thanks for the raid. How's everybody doing? What are you up to? Or what did you get up to? Let me see. Panda, if you're not already following Panda, click the little follow button. What the fuck is up, Denny's? yo, there's a logout extension for 10 minutes on this update. So that's pretty hype. Pretty hype. Now I don't have to run like crazy every time I like go. Not AFK timer. AFK logout timer. So like, you don't use the Jagex account? Okay, yeah. 5 minutes. 5 minutes right now is the case right now. So like, when you're mining or something, you can just... 25 minutes is a little too much. I feel like, man. 25 minutes is a little too much. But also, let's quickly check out a clip from Panda's stream. Let me pause the music. Let's see what pops up. A random clip. Oh, he's opening clues. Shadow die. That's a big opening. You got like lots of gilded. You got backstab cape, barrel, shadow, two shadow dies. That's from your two card 2 years ago. Damn. Okay. But yeah, that's the only good thing on this update. But yeah, we're just reading through the patch notes. See, Treasure Hunter calendar ends. See, anything really good? No. Oh, Protein Prolonger. I don't know what this is. New to this run are the Protein Prolonger, which lets you double the maximum make X value for your proteins for a limited time. Okay, interesting. So, that'll be nice for... That'll be nice for more MTX stuff. Yep. more spending. Well, for me, it's just spending my oddments for for Treasure Hunter keys daily. I just spend. Well, I'm out of oddments now, but I every day I buy 10 Treasure Hunter keys with oddments. That's it. Alright, let's see patch notes. With the recent update to construction via Fort Frin 3, protein planks have been redesigned to be more in line with other protein resources. Okay. I wonder... I hope only one plank is required to make a wooden table or something. Instead of it being like 8 protein planks equals one wooden mahogany table. Let's see what this update is going to be, I guess. Protein planks can no longer be used to build things. Wait, what? And you cannot cut protein logs into planks. You can still convert them, but through the usual 3-2 conversion of any protein. Okay. You cannot make any objects from planks anymore. Okay. Just planks to give you XP. Okay. That's good. Because it was kind of dumb that you could make protein frames and sell, elder frames with proteins and sell it. So, this is a good nerf. They now behave more like protein bars where players have level banded make X interaction. Consume one plank at a time, yep, at the rate of 1 every 7 ticks. This can be reduced to 6 with protein power ups. Okay. To start the make X interaction, player will need to interact with either construction hotspot in their player owned house or a workbench. Oh, wait, are they making a. Like, in the player owned house, like, you can, just constantly. I haven't done construction in the house in so long. But, IMO planks were kind of dog shit before. Ate too many resources. Yeah. That's true. Slow build in the house, I guess. Yeah. These changes represent a decrease in XP per hour from the items, but also represent a decrease in skill intensity. It is, however, a buff to the XP per protein plank. Topping out at level 90 with 2x2.25, fix an issue that showed an incorrect teleport option for the Elder Divination Head. When the divination stat was less than level 10. Interesting. I always wonder, like, how people find these issues. Like, why are your stats below level 10 and you're wearing elder divination armor, you know? It's back up? Yeah. Yo, what's up, Tapatuli? Stay tuned, because I'm doing some elite clues after this. I do have tips. So. It's just more just like learning the teleports and this and that. Don't listen to Panda Elite Clues, Best Clues. Yo, my first comment, keep grinding, just join. Yo, what's up, Zezima 12? Nice seeing Zezima here. Number 12. Fix an issue where... Okay, I read that. Fix an issue where Andrea, I don't know how to say this person's name, did not appear in Thalador's throne room during Twilight of the Gods. Quest at the Legacy of Zamrock season is complete. Okay. Does doing 9 hards and an elite for the 10th will work? No. It doesn't work like that, Tapatuli. Hard clues only... Like, if you're doing hard clues, only, each is tier-based, exactly what, Panda said. Every is tier-based, so, like, you have to do 10 elite clues to get the 10th point, or the 50th point, or the 100th, and then you gotta do hard clues, same thing. You can't do it like Slayer. You can't... I wish, that would be kinda cool, but that would be kinda broken, too. Just do, like, every 10th clue, just do a master clue. For the most points. Yeah. Okay, let's see. Dead and Buried prevented undead from dropping more map pieces than necessary. Okay, this is the newest quest that happened. There's a lot of updates for that quest. Okay, prevented raptor transmogrification from persisting if the player teleports out of a dead and buried instance. Okay. Fix a typing error in the minor wisdom achievement. Nightmares in the dream can no longer be killed by poison or reflect damage. Okay. The raptor now leans his mace on his shoulders during the two town hall scenes. Okay.
Hey, what's your Wi-Fi password?
Yo. Zezima, Wi-Fi password, elite clues, best clues. You're reaching out to Shogun? What a weird meta that would develop. Oh yeah, it would be. I wouldn't be against that update, Panda, if they made us do like the best clue every 10th, 50th, 100th. It'd be kind of cool. Players will no longer get stuck inside the burning house during Raptor's Dream. Fix an issue that caused the construction time of the Ranger's workroom tier to have an unexpected value. Movement abilities are now restricted. That kind of sucks. To prevent players from diving onto another pressure plate. Oh, okay. Fix an issue causing... I thought it was like surge and play a dive and stuff. Okay. Corrected the positioning of an arrow stand. Oh, wait. Panda, what did you do in stream? I don't know if I missed it or not. I must have missed it. Let's see. Corrected the positioning of an arrow stand that was attempting to escape Fort Town roof. Let's see. The zombies have been firmly reminded that they are not speed zombies. Henceforth, they shall walk, not run. Okay. Gave Sophia the Ranger workroom a Fletcher's outfit. Okay. In response to player feedback, updated the Raptors examine from who can move in all that armor to a mysterious warrior clad in thick plate armor. And replaces casual angry posture. Wait, his? Isn't Raptor a girl? Alright. And replaced her casual angry posture with either a modified variant of her original weapon on shoulder, shield in hand, or another more natural pose. Okay. Okay, somebody made some, cool, rings. It's cool. Reaver rings, okay. Somebody drew this? That's pretty cool. Rat Girl HRS. With a beautiful illustration of God of Chaos. Oh, that's okay. And then this. Oh, okay. That's nice. Painted her own character. Fashionscape. Okay. A friend gives you a guide on necromancy launch. Waydots realizes necromancy is just around the corner. Oh, what was his goal? I wonder what his goal was. Rayo's legacy locked series continues. Firmly set on getting a Zamorakian spear, okay. Elige and Born having a heated debate about who has to cook tonight, okay. Beep doesn't seem content on just having two green swords and has his sight on something a little bigger. Right, okay. Oh, nice grats, this guy who got 99 construction. That should hold him. Okay, cool. Oh, but yeah, they could go for 120 construction now that protein planks are changed. Link's pink skirt player events. Let's see. Town Square Q&A. Penguin tour. If you've never done penguins or like hunt for penguins, it's nice to go with a group of people in World 60. But you could do it alone. I don't, like, since I do clues, like, I always see penguins all around. I think it was a hint that we need to remax. Oh, okay. could be. Stealing Creation, let's see. Oh, Stealing Creation kind of is cool. Like a mini game with everybody there. With Fast SC. World 99 on July 29th. Okay. I haven't played Stealing Creation in so long. That was a fun game, actually. Whenever you're on the good side, anyways. Like, if there's too many, like, PVMers on the other side, and they're just ice barraging you the whole time, every time you like leave the entrance. Yeah. Stealing Creation was fun, yeah. Alright. Pretty good update. Logout timer 10 minutes.